This is Scott Spears, and on May 16, 2014, the most iconic female broadcaster of our time, Barbara Walters, is calling it a day after 53 years in the broadcast business. Joining us to look back on her amazing career is the Grand Dame of Gossip in New York, and a friend, longtime close friend of Miss Walters for many years, Liz Smith. Liz, how are you?
I'm just doing fine. And though Barbara Walters is retiring, quote, I'm afraid I'm not. And I probably should, but I'm having a really good time writing for the Chicago Tribune papers and for the New York Social Diary and Huffington Post and various internet things. How are you? How are things in Ohio?
Things are great, and we miss you. We've got to get together more often, Liz. On the telephone, that is.
Okay.
Liz, I want to start here. Exactly, you said the word retirement. What do you make of this? Is this a Johnny Carson retirement? We'll never see her again? What do you make of it?
Oh, I think we'll see her again every time there's a major, you know, international name, and ABC has all of that valuable stuff of hers to put on the television to remind us. And I think Barbara looks great. She is doing just fine, and she belies her age, I don't think she's going to be gone. She's just not going to be regular.
So then, why do this? Why make this exit?
Well, because if she stays, she's always on call, and she has to work as hard as ABC wants her to. And they find her wherever she is. If she's on vacation and she feels obligated to come back, you know, I think she does want to get rid of a little bit of the pressure of having a contract and having to be available. For instance, I know she's going to go to Europe and try to see things like a regular person. You know, I once went to Egypt with Barbara, and we were just supposed to be having a good time. We were with a big party of people, and we were just pursued all over Egypt for her to come and meet important people, and she didn't resist that. You know, she's just loyal to news. So, I remember we were walking through the Temple of Karnak, which is a great big thing, and she said, I may be dead this time next year. And I said, oh, don't be ridiculous. You know, that was a long time ago, and she was already pressured to death. So I think it's just a matter of taking her own life into her own hands.
So you would say, Liz, that, and I think she's not leaving this planet anytime soon, if a new president would come along, you think she'd request an interview?
Well, they might request an interview with her. The front page of the Times today does a really interesting job about how she's the last of the great gets. I mean, a great get is getting somebody famous who nobody else can get. And it doesn't mean what it used to, because news is so discussed and ubiquitous, and nobody can get a scoop anymore because it's all on, you know, the internet.
You know, Liz, David Letterman on The View this week said one of the reasons he's leaving is because of this social media, and it's time to go. He doesn't keep up with it like the other guys do. Is there any of that with Barbara?
I don't know. She probably knows more about... Boy, I agree with David Letterman, which is rare. But Barbara may know more about social media because she's been on The View so much, you know, since she helped form The View. And but she doesn't want to probably have to keep up with a who is who and who the Kardashians are doing something ridiculous with next.
Liz, I introduced you as the grand dame of gossip, so I have two questions for you, and maybe we'll get an answer, maybe we won't.
Okay.
Who do you see in line to take that seat next season? You can't replace Barbara Walters on The View, but who's going to fill it?
Well, I guess some of these people, I don't even know their names. I know Whoopi will probably, this is a guess, she's a friend of mine, and I think Whoopi will stay. Some of these big names are enduring, like Bette Midler and Whoopi and Cher, but, you know, even they are worried. Are they a little insecure because they don't feel their attraction is great? And the way news is, let's just call it news, the way news is handled these days, everything is used up in the day and all night, and people are just surfeited with it. And in other words, the things that we're seeing on social media are not so important, I don't think, as they used to be when they were scarce or rare, or you didn't see anybody all the time. Like candidates, presidential candidates, people who are undeclared, we're already sick of them. And we haven't even had an election.
You're exactly right about that, Liz. I think it's a pretty safe bet that Whoopi and Jenny McCarthy and Sherry will be back, but is there a name floating? Who's going to fill that quartet out?
Not that I know of. Not that Barbara has ever said anything. She just talks about wanting to rest, and as soon as she gets off of it, she'll think of something else to do.
Here's one other gossip question, Liz. The other night on Letterman, I don't know if you saw Barbara on Letterman. I guess it would have been Wednesday.
I missed that.
Letterman asked her a question about Monica Lewinsky, and they got into it's hard for her to get a job. And Letterman said something, well, what about her on The View? And Barbara didn't take a stern no and almost kind of hem-hawed a little bit about it. And, you know... Is that?
Well, I didn't know this happened. And it's a great idea. Monica Lewinsky on The View. Oh, I think it's great.
I think there could be something to that, Liz. You have to put your ear to the ground on that one.
Oh, my gosh. Well, you certainly told me something this morning. It's incredible.
Yeah, get that.
Can I just say I'm no longer a, quote, gossip columnist? Now I just write whatever appeals to me every day, and there is a limited demand for that because people want something salacious, and, you know, I just can't do that stuff. It's not that I didn't stoop to do it in the past, and when I could, I did it, but I'm more of a philosopher commentator now.
That
I do appreciate a news bit, and that you certainly gave me food for thought.
Well, I tell you, Liz, check out that clip of her on Letterman and see how she answered that question. It was very interesting, and go from there. I know we're on limited time, Liz, so I've got to ask you these two questions. You know Barbara personally. Tell us something we don't know about Barbara Walters, the person.
Well, I don't think she's much of a romantic. I think she's a realist. The thing I am impressed most, I have done a lot of charity work in addition to writing for a living. And she has literally never had time for that. But to make up for that, she is one of the most generous people I've ever met. She just has helped so many charities and given away money and influence and prestige. And that is really good. And I hope that the hoopla around her, quote, retirement will reassure her. I think she's a little insecure about being loved and admired. And she's tough, you know, a realist, and sometimes she's hard to get along with, but she's a really at heart,
you know,
generous, loyal friend.
You know, I think, Liz, and again, I know we're on limited time, but it's an interesting thing you just brought up. When she was doing the news, the straight news, 2020, so on and so forth, there was never conflict, and The View did show a different side of her, but those kind of knockdown dragouts with Star Jones and Rosie O'Donnell, I think, painted her a little differently, that maybe she was a hard-nosed businesswoman, and she didn't...
Well, I don't think she was. I don't think she was too clever about giving away control of The View, and a lot of us urged her to be tougher and more in her own corner. But she is a control freak to a certain extent. I find most talented people are like that. They appear tough because they're responsibilities and burdens are just enormous. And you know, to have people pulling at your sleeve all the time. I mean, she's a big name, and even in New York, people pester her, won't leave her alone, and tell her they're, and they come up to her and say things like, "My grandmother is a great fan of yours." Like, you know, the person isn't. I think she's kind of misunderstood, and she doesn't always get along with the people she's hired herself. And Rosie is tough too, and Joy Behar is smart and brilliant, and so she was the boss of The View.
You know,
and now she's letting go.
Will she be able to, becomes the question, though.
Well, she'll have to do that. She could always come back as a guest, but I think time passes and things change.
Liz, we talk about this in a lot of fields. We always say, does this person go up on Mount Rushmore? And I think in news, we have Walter Cronkite, Edward R. Murrow. Those are the safe bets. Does Barbara Walters go up there?
Yes. And because of what she did, either inadvertently for herself and her own ambition, but she certainly broke the glass ceiling for women. And now women are demanding equal rights all over the place. The prominent story these days is not terrorists or anything international. It's women's rights.
I think you're right, Liz. And I want to wrap with this. You're one of the few rare world who has Barbara Walters' phone number, I'm sure. Will you call her tonight, and if so, what will you say?
Well, I figure she's just snowed under with stuff, and I won't call her. I have sent her emails, brief emails, cheering her on and saying, I saw you. Like, I sent her one yesterday saying, you look so beautiful in the current Vanity Fair. And it's so like you to be sitting there surrounded by the Financial Times and the Wall Street Journal and New York Times. And she always answers me. How does she have time? I hardly have time to answer my email, and I'm certainly, not missed like she will be.
Well, Liz, it certainly is an historic time. There's no doubt about it. And I think she does go up on Mount Rushmore. If there are four names, Barbara Walters is a shoo-in there. I can't thank you enough for joining me, and I hope Barbara Walters starts doing some radio interviews now that she's got some free time, because I think a lot of us would love to talk with her.
Okay, I'm going to recommend that she call you.
That's the best recommendation.
When I see her, when she gets back from Europe or wherever she's going to go visit all the museums. She'll get tired of that.
That's right. She'll need to talk to somebody. That's the best recommendation I could have asked for. Liz, you're always a dear guest, and I thank you so much.
Okay. Call me anytime.
Take care, Liz. Bye-bye.
Bye.